sarcasm, that he's being sarcastic here about this, Jeffrey Lord. So which is it? Is he saying, no, they're actually the founders, or is he doing what everybody else would do, which is being sarcastic?
Chris, let me just say, before I depart on my vacation to New York, to Long Island, New Yorkers, as my entire family have a sarcastic sense of humor.
Really?
Really, exactly, exactly right. Chris, I understand you exactly when I hear you talk, because you're a New Yorker. I understand Donald Trump. Donald Trump is exactly right about this. He was, to borrow from President Kennedy after the Bay of Pigs, Barack Obama was the responsible officer of the government. He was in charge. It was right. His decision to remove those troops. It was his decision that launched what is now ISIS. There is no question about it. He and Secretary Clinton were and are the responsible officers of the government for this decision.
Why didn't he just say that, Jeffrey? And one theory as to why, especially when he said Barack Hussein Obama, was that it was a little bit of a dog whistle effect. It's a little bit of, let's make our president feel like a traitor, like he was trying to do during the birther movement. You know, what about that whisper?
Chris, A, that's the president's name. I mean, I don't see anything wrong with it. But the point that he's making here, and frankly, Chris, look, this is the American left in foreign policy since at least George McGovern. They assured us that if we got out of Vietnam, there would be peace. Instead, there was mass murder. Mm. I mean, on and on and on and on this goes. This is the stated position of the Democratic Party, the American left. They got to put this in practice, and now the world is a mess. It is a disaster.
All right, let's get to the general for some perspective.
Secretary of State is responsible for it.
All right, let's go to the general and get some perspective. Now that we've talked about the political byplay here, General, I won't burden you with that. But just for clarity's sake, in 2007, Donald Trump told Wolf Blitzer, we should get out of Iraq immediately. Get out. Declare victory and get out. And he has in the past, blamed George Bush for being responsible for ISIS. Now he's saying it's President Obama. What is your take on why ISIS exists today, if you were going to ascribe some blame?
Well, this gets to the point, Chris. First of all, Mr. Trump is semantically incorrect in describing all this. And secondly, it shows he's patently uninformed about the rift between the Shia and the Sunni and the governments in the Middle East. He's also shown repeatedly an inability to understand this as a complex issue. That's part of the problem. But finally, going to Jeffrey's point, his ability to communicate, I'm married to a New Yorker too, and unfortunately the whole world doesn't come from New York. A leadership requirement is to communicate correctly, and Mr. Trump has failed to do that to others in the world outside of New York, and I'm one of those. But to go to the Shia-Sunni rift, you know, there have been experts on your program and others that talk about who is responsible for the rise of ISIS. It was Zawahiri primarily in a recent environment, but this goes back decades and even centuries in terms of what has generated this problem. And, you know, you're talking about terrorism that relates back to the 60s, the 70s, the 80s in this part of the world. And yes, have different politicians, to include President Obama, perhaps contributed to all of this by their actions? Yes. If Mr. Trump would have said that, it would have been a different story. And he was given that option by Hugh Hewitt, as you showed a little while ago, and he refused to take it. Instead, it's a complete slash and disrespect to the president, another issue that I have with him in terms of his leadership qualities. But it also appeals to a bunch of people that don't really understand how complex this issue is, and the number of people like me who have fought against elements like ISIS.
Jeffrey, we hear
Chris,
that.
If I could just agree with the general on one thing. This problem does go back centuries. On September 11th, I believe, of 1683, Islamic forces were at the gates of Vienna and saying that they were going to behead people and rape the women, et cetera, trying to take over what was then, you know, the gate of the Western world. This has been going on for centuries, which is explicitly why the president's refusal to call it radical Islam and deal with its roots is so troubling.
Jeffrey, we hear that Donald Trump is going to give a talk of some kind about how to defeat radical Islam.